watching me everywhere
you want to
go. I want to tell that there's something behind. There's something behind all the sickness that we see. There's something behind those Ebola. There's something behind HIV. There's something behind
COVID-19.
There's something behind all this pandemic and sicknesses that and there are others who will come and came. There's something behind. May God help us. All the sickness that see upon Job, they have been planned in the spiritual world. And the Bible has told us that Satan went out from the presence of God and struck Job with painful boils from the sole of his foot up to the crown of his head. My friend, now you are being revealed about the source of all these problems.
There's
a meeting that Satan did for the spiritual world so that he can strike your family, that he can strike your business, so that he can strike the farm of your cows, so that he come to your chicken. I'm here to tell you that there's something behind. There's something behind your weakness. There's something behind your failure. You sleep well, but in the morning you feel so weak. The whole day you are fine, but during the evening you are weak. There's something behind it. Satan, the enemy of God and people, is the one who is behind it. That. In all words that I've told you before, it's very important to know your true enemy. When you don't know the enemy you are fighting with, you might fight with another one who is not your enemy. And it's a big problem in fighting is to fight with the one who you are not supposed to fight. I'm here to tell you that the thing that we're passing through, there's something behind.
Blessing upon you, to your friend following us on Thousand Comforts.
I know that
you are following us everywhere around the world.
As usual,
you are with your friend Kaitari
Jean-Baptiste. I welcome you
to chapter 9, talking about the spiritual
world. Today I'm
going to talk about the title of the message, saying there's something behind.
So without
delaying, let's read in the book of Job.
We are
going to read chapter 1 from verse 13 up to 22.
Maze umunsi umwe abahungu be n'abakobwa be barasangiraga banywera vino mu nzu ya mukuru wabo, nuko haza imbitsi kuri Yobu iti, amapfizi yahingaga n'indogobe zarishaga iruhande rwayo, maze abasheba babyirukamo barabinyaga, ndetse bicishije abagaragu inkota, ninjye warokotse njyenyine wo kubikubikira. Akimara kubika ibyo, haza undi ati umurimo umuriro w'Imana wavuye mu ijuru utwika intama n'abagaragu birakongoka, ninjye warokotse njyenyine wo kubikurikira. Akibivuga haza undi ati abakarudaya biremyemo inteko biremyemo ibitero bitatu bisuka mu ngamiya barazinyaga ndetse bicisha bagaraga inkota ni nge warokotse ngenyine wo kubikubikira akibivuga haza undi ati abahungu bawe n'abakobwa bawe basangiraga banywera vino mu nzu ya mukuru wabo nuko haza inkubi y'umuyaga iturutse mu butayu ihitana imfuruka enye z'inzu maze inzu igwira abo basore barapfa ni nge warokotse ngenyine wo kubikubikira maze Yobu ahera ko ahaguruka ashishimura umwitero we arimo arimoza yikubita hasi arasenga ati navuye mu nda ya mama nambaye ubusa nzasubira mu nda y'isi ntacyo nambaye Uwiteka niwe wabimpaye kandi Uwiteka niwe ubintwaye izina ry'Uwiteka nirishimwe muri ibyo byose Yobu ntiyakoze icyaha haba no kubiherereza ku Mana.
We are going to read in Job chapter 1 from verse 13 up to 22. Let's read in the name of Jesus. Now there was a day when his sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine in their oldest brother's house. And the messenger came to Job and said, the oxen were plowing and the donkeys feeding beside them when the Sibians raided them and took them away. Indeed, they have killed the servants with the edge of sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you. 16. While he was still speaking, another came and said, the fire of God fell from heaven and burned up the sheep and the servants and consumed them, and I alone have escaped to tell you. 17. While he was still speaking, another also came and said, the Chaldeans formed three bands, raided the camels and took them away, yes, and killed the servants with the edge of sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you. 18. While he was still speaking, another also came and said, your sons and daughter were eating and drinking wine in the oldest brother's house, and suddenly a great wind came from across the wilderness and struck the four corners of the house, and it fell on the young people, and they all are dead, and I alone have escaped to tell you. 20. Then Job arose, tore his robe, and shaved his head, and he fell to the ground and worshipped, and said, naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all this, Job did not sin, nor charge God with wrong. Amen. Let's pray. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for giving us another time to give your word upon your people. Please be with us in all this time. May your word continue to help all who are following us everywhere in the world. Thank you for being with us, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray.
Amen.
Amen. May Heavenly Father be glorified. I've read a mystery of a man called Job, who used to live in the country of Uz. The Bible says that this man called Job, he was a righteous man who respected God and get away of their sins. So that every people in the East, no one was more rich than him. Because of that respect of and being righteous, God has given him a lot of wealth. He was blessed of having kids. He had boys and girls. And he had a rich of other things. He had oxen. He had sheep.
akagira n'ingamiya
and camels
nanditse n'abagaragu
and even servants.
Muri ibyo bihe umuntu wabaga afite ibyo bintu,
in that time someone when he used to have those kind of things,
yabaga ari umukire wo mu rwego rwo hejuru.
He was a very rich man.
Yarafite n'inzu,
he had a house,
inzu ya etage,
the granite house.
Urumva ko yobu yari umuntu ukomeye rwose.
It means that Job was a great man.
Ah, dusomye amagambo menshi rero avuga ku byamubayeho.
We have read a lot of story about him.
Aravuga ku bitero bine byabaye kuri Yobu.
Talking about four attacks that happens to Job.
Iyo utangiye usoma ku murongo wa 13,
when you start reading from verse 13,
ukabona ibyabaye kuri Yobu byose,
and you see all that happened to Job,
ubaye uri umuntu utarigeze usoma imirongo ibanza y'igice cya Yobu cya mbere,
if you are like someone who have never read the previous verses about this scripture of Job,
tuvuge wenda ukaba uri umuntu utarigeze usoma Bibiliya na rimwe,
maybe you are like someone who didn't read Bible,
ukaza gutoragura n'urupapuro rwo mu gitabo cya Yobu,
then he took a piece of paper in the book of Job,
ugatoragura n'urupapuro rwacitseho igice cyo hejuru,
then you found like a rotten paper just which is written all this that you have read,
hasigayeho uyu murongo wa 13 kugeza ku 22 gusa,
then you find that it's only from this verse 13 up to 22.
Murongo wa mbere kugeza kwa 12 bibaye nta biriho.
When from verse 1 up to 12 for this chapter 1 is not there.
Aya makuru ukaba utarigeze ugira handi hantu hamwe uyumva.
And you have never heard this news.
Wakibwira ngo ni ibyorezo byari byabaye kuri Yobu.
You might think that it was like a pandemic that happened to this man Job.
Bibiliya itubwiye ko igitero cya mbere cyagabwe kuri Yobu.
The Bible has told us that the first attack that happened to this man Job.
N'abantu bitwa Abasheba.
It's people called the Sibians.
Abasheba biraye mu mitungo ya Yobu.
Those Sibians, they come to the things of Job.
Banyaga imfizi zose zamuhingiraga.
Then they took all the oxen.
Bica n'abagaragu be bose.
And they killed servants.
Ubisomye utarigeze umenya ko hari cyari kiri inyuma y'ibi bintu.
If you have to read without knowing that there was something behind all these things.
Wajya ngo n'abantu bonye rugomo gusa.
You might think that there are people who are laborers only.
Cyangwa ukagira ngo n'abantu bo mu mitwe y'iterabwoba.
Or you might think that they are like terrorists.
Imana idufate cyane.
God help us a lot.
Hanyuma igitero cya kabiri cyagabwe kuri Yobu.
Then the second attack upon Job.
Bibiliya ivuga ko ari umuriro wavuye mu ijuru ugatwika intama ze n'abagaragu.
The Bible says that is the fire from heaven that came and burn all the ships and servants.
Nabwo uba utarasomye imirongo yo hejuru.
And if you would not be aware of what happened before,
wagira ngo ni ikiza nubwo cyabaye.
You might think that it's also a pandemic.
Mujya mubyumva muri za Australia no mu Burayi.
Many times you have heard in Australia or in Europe.
No muri za Amerika n'ahandi.
Even in USA.
Hajya haka imiriro idafite uwayicanye.
There are some fire that comes without being fired on.
Kandi ikangiza ibintu byinshi cyane.
And they destroy a lot of things.
Habaye hari abahanga n'ikoranabuhanga nk'ibiri iki gihe.
If there should be wise men and technology like you have today.
Bavuga ko ari umuriro wapfuye kwaka gusa.
Could they say that it's an automatic fire?
Hanyuma igitero cya gatatu cyagabwe kuri Yobu.
Then the third attack.
Kitwa Abakarudaya.
It's called the Chaldeans.
Abo Bakarudaya nabo.
And those Chaldeans.
Baraje nabo birara mu mitungo ye.
They formed three bands and came to his property.
Bamutwarira ingamiya bamwicira n'abagaragu.
They have taken away camels and killed all the servants.
Hanyuma harokoka umugaragu umwe.
Then only one servant left.
Aba nabo babashyira mu rwego rw'aba bandi ba mbere.
Even these people, this kind of people you can take like from the first level. Ugatekereza
ari imitwe y'amabandi cyangwa abandi bajura.
And you might think that they are bandits or this kind of thieves.
Hanyuma igitero cya kane bibiri vuba ko ari umuyaga.
Then the fourth attack, the Bible says that it's a wind.
Umuyaga uturutse iburasirazuba.
It's a wind across the wilderness.
Uraza usenya inzu ya Yobu.
And destroy the house of Job.
Abahungu be n'abakobwa be bari bayirimo nuko bose barapfa.
And his sons and daughter, they all died.
Ah, Bibiliya itweretse ko ibi byose byabaye kuri Yobu.
The Bible has told us that all this happened to Job.
Byabaga byikurikiranya mu kanya gato cyane.
That they came one after another.
Imbitsi ya mbere yaraje mubwira ibyo abashemba bakoze.
One messenger came and told him about Shibians.
Atarangiza kubivuga ya kabiri birahageze.
Without finishing taking the second messenger came.
Imubwira ku muhumuro watwitsi ntamba n'abagaragu.
Told him about the fire out burns ships and the servants.
Atiraho imbitsi ya gatatu birahageze.
Immediately the third messenger came.
Imubwira kuno abakaudaye bazira imuzo bakazitwara kwica n'abagaragu.
And told him about the camels, how they have been taken away and the servants killed.
Iyo mbitsi yihagaza aho ngaho.
While that messenger was around,
yakaniraza imubwira ukuntu umuyaga wishe abana be bose.
The fourth one immediately came and told him about how the kids have been dying.
Yo biza kuba ari mu gihe cy'ikoranabuhanga nk'ubu.
If it should be like in this moment of technology.
Hamaze kubaho abahanga mu bumenyi bw'ikirere.
While they were wise men according to the technology.
Bari kuvuga ko uriya muriro ufite indi mpamvu yawuteye.
They would say that this kind of fire had another reason.
Bakavuga ko hanyuma uriya muyaga bakawita izina.
And they call that kind of wind a name.
Umuyaga bakawita jani nkuko mujya mubyumva.
They would maybe call it Jen, like you have heard another wind.
Umuyaga igiza bakayita amazina.
There are some winds that are coming, they call names like those Katrina.
Aligitwa za tsunami n'ibindi byagiye bibaho.
Yeah, those with the tsunami and Katrina and others.
Bakawabyita amazina nkuko mujya mubyumva.
So that they might name them like you have heard before.
Imana idufate cyane.
May God help us a lot.
Ariko ijambo ry'Imana,
by the word of God,
uyebe ku murongo w'umunani w'igice cya mbere cya Yobu,
from verse 8 of chapter 1
kugeza ku murongo wa 12
up to 12,
hatwereka ko ibyabaye kuri Yobu harahandi byari byateguriwe.
This what happened to Job, it shows us that before there was planned.
Ibitero byose bine bikurikirana byabaye kuri Yobu mu gice cya mbere.
All those four attacks that happened to Job,
bifite ahantu byari byateguwe.
They have where they came from.
Bibitwe ko Satani,
the Bible has told us that Satan,
ari we wari wasabye Yobu kugira ngo amugerageze.
Who is the one who wanted to tempt Job?
Hari icyari kibyihishe inyuma.
There is something, there was something behind.
Abashemba nibyo barateye.
The Shibians, yes, they came.
Banyaga imfizi zari bamwica n'abagaragu.
They took all the oxen and the servants.
Ariko abashemba ntabwo ari bo bari babyibwirije.
By the Shibians, they were not the one to come and took all these things.
Satani wari wateguye iki gitero.
Satan used them for this attack.
Niwe wari wateguye iki gitero neza.
He was the one who prepared this attack.
Imana idufashe cyane.
May God help us.
Bibiliya itubwira ko Satani,
the Bible says that Satan,
yavuye imbere y'Imana akagaba ibitero byose kuri Yobu.
He came out of front of God and bring all those attacks to Job.
Niwe winjiye mu bitekerezo bya Abashemba.
He's the one who entered in the thoughts of Shibians.
Abahuriza hamwe.
And take them together.
Abemeza kugaba igitero kuri Yobu.
And they made them to decide that they have to attack Job.
Mwene data mushiki wanjye unkurikiye.
My brother, my sister, who is following me.
Ndagira ngo ubwire ko ibirimo kukubaho byose.
I want to tell you that whatever happening to you,
hari ikibyihishe inyuma.
There's something behind.
Urabona abanzi abahoze ari inshuti zawe baraguhagurukiye.
See that those who were your friends, they come up to you.
Bahindutse abanzi bawe.
They have become your enemies.
Abagomba kugira icyo bakumarira.
Those who used to help you,
ubu niwe barimo kukwangirira.
Now they are the one to destroy you.
Ndagira ngo nkumenere ibanga.
I'm here to reveal your secret.
Hari ikibyihishe.
There's something behind that.
Satani umugome,
Satan the wicked one,
umwanzi w'Imana n'abantu,
the enemy of God and people,
niwe wihishe inyuma y'iyo ntambara.
Is the one behind all those that fighting that you are fighting.
Ndagira ngo uhanure wa mugabo.
I'm here to prophesize for you, man.
Ndagira ngo uhanure wa mugabo.
For you, woman.
Ndagira ngo uhanure wa mukobwa na wa musore.
For you, young girl and young boy.
Ndagira ngo uhanure wa mushumba
we. I'm here to prophesize for you, prophet.
Ndagira ngo uhanure wa muyobozi we.
You, the leader.
Mu rwego urwo ari rwo rwose.
In each kind of level.
Ibi birimo guhura nabyo mu buzima.
Whatever you are facing,
hari ikibyihishe.
There's something behind.
Imana idufate cyane.
God help us.
Ntabwo abashemba bonyine aribo bibwirije.
The Shibians, they are not the one to decide.
Gutera Yobu ngo bamutware imfizi bamwice n'abagaragu.
To attack Job and take the oxen and kill servants.
Hari ikintu cyari kibyihishe.
There was something behind that.
Imana idufate cyane.
May God help us a lot.
Bibiliya yatweretse n'uyu muriro.
The Bible has shown us even this fire.
Uyu muriro wari ikiza urebesha amaso n'umubiri cy'abagisanzwe.
This man, this fire was like an normal epidemic. This fire and wind that has put down this house of Job.
I'm
here to tell you that they were not normal. My brother, my sister, I'm here to tell you that those epidemics that you see, all these winds, all this earthquake, the lack of rain, and those who rain, they rain just in a bad way. There's something behind all these losses that you are finding. The all this quarreling that you find in your family, the study of your kids and they get a few marks, the girls of your family are pregnant, they are like an abnormal pregnancy. It's not only because they are bad, but there's something behind.
May
God help us a lot. Satan has a plan for that. In his world of spirits, things that we see here that are tangible, they are all planned in the spiritual world. All these conflicts that you see in the world, all these infinite wars, all this hatred and killing that you see, all conflict that you see in the families and churches, there's something behind. Satan, the enemy of God and people,
is
the one who planned all this that happened. All bad things that are happening to you, they are caused by Satan. Oh, may God be with us. My friend, I want to tell you, all these childrens that came and took the camels of Job, there was something behind. All this terrorist group of terrorists that you see in different countries, the wickedness, the hatred, and all bad things that you find in the around the world, Satan, the enemy of God and people, is the one who is the planner.
May
God be with us. May God help us. In the first attack that Satan brought to Job, in this chapter 1 of Job, Satan brought 4 consecutive attacks. The Bible says that Job continued to be righteous, and he just fell down and arose again, and he said, naked I came from my mother's womb, and that's where I will return without any clothes. Job says all is God who have given them
to me.
And the Bible is telling us that Job did never sin. My brother, my sister,
all
that is happening to you is not to take you away from God. People in different parts of the world, they are calling me, and some are telling me, Pastor Kaitare, I have a lot of problems, so that I want even to kill myself. I want to tell you, my brother, my sister, this is what Satan wants. Satan wants you to kill yourself and you die and perish, because there's no love between you and Satan. May God be with us. And the second chapter 2 in the book of Job, we also find another attack that Satan brought to Job. And the first chapter, we have seen all these 4 attacks. They didn't remove God from God's Job, from God's mercy. Because Satan was thinking that for Job to have kids and wealthy, Satan was thinking that they are the one that are helping Job to obey God. So Satan was thinking that if he took them away, Job will come out of God. My brother, my sister, I'm here to tell you that the plan of Satan is beyond your imagination. The great plan of Satan is just to destroy you and separate you with the belief and separate you with peace and separate you with eternal life. That's the plan of Satan upon your life. I want you to stand firm like
that.
Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, be glorified. The Bible is telling us that the servant of God
said
that he did never sin and never put any sin against God. Briefly, this attack that had consecutive four attacks for the plan of Satan for Job, this attack failed because the whole soil of God of Job continued to be righteous. Oh, Heavenly Father, be glorified. Let's read Job chapter 2. We're going to read verse 7 and
8.
Satan is always fighting.
While
I was starting this scripture saying the spiritual war, in the first part when I was talking about the names of Satan, I told you that Satan is an adversary. Though you know that he will lose, he just keep on. He knew that Job will win him. That it doesn't stop Satan to bring attacks to Job. Let's read Job chapter 2, verse 7 and 8.
Tani ayarako arasohoka ava imbere y'Uwiteka ateza ibishyute bibi bihera mu bworo bw'ikirenge bigeza mu gitwariro. Nuko yishakira urujyo rwo kwishimisha maze yicara mu ivu.
It says in English, Job chapter 2, we read verse 7 and 8. So Satan went out from the presence of the Lord and struck Job with painful boils from the sole of his foot to the crown of his head. And he took for himself a potsherd with which to scrape himself while he sat in the midst of the ashes. Amen. If you read this chapter 2 from verse
7,
and you only read verse
7
and
8
only, and without starting all this verse
7,
you might think like it's like a pandemic of sickness that came to Job. The Bible has told us that Satan went out from the presence of the Lord and struck Job with a painful boils. The boils from the sole of his foot to the crown of his head. They were so painful. I want you, my friend who is listening to me, just think about this sickness of Job.
There
is a time that a sickness is surprising and touch someone, and in a few minutes you find him is about to die. There's a time you find someone that has a lot of boils. Then the whole body is full of boils. And even Job, just all these boils came, the Bible is telling us that they start from foot. The reason why they start from foot, they wanted to stop even Job to walk. Satan is a wicked, my brother. Then up to the crown of his head. If there was big hospitals for these boils,
bari gupima bakabona n'amavirusi yabyo.
They should have test and find the viruses, the reason of this body.
Nandetse bakaba banabona n'inkomoko yabyo.
And maybe they might find the source of these boils.
Bakavuga bati wenda byatewe n'inkende.
They say maybe they have caused by monkeys.
Wenda byatewe n'ubucurama.
Or maybe they have called by this crow belts.
Yuza kumujyana mu bitaro byacu by'i Kanombe cyangwa muri Faisal na Seashka.
If you take maybe to Seashka or Kanombe or King Faisal Hospital.
Cyangwa mu Buhinde no muri Amerika.
Or maybe in India or USA.
Bari kumupima bakabona ama virus atera ibi bibyimba.
They test and find the viruses causing those boils.
Bakavuga ko ari indwara zisanzwe.
And they said that it's a normal sickness.
Cyangwa ari icyorezo.
Or maybe an epidemic.
Cyangwa ari indwara y'inzaduka.
Or maybe it's a new coming sickness.
Bagatangira gushaka wenda urukingo.
They start finding vaccine.
Bagashaka n'umuti wabivura.
Or maybe the treatments that can be against all these.
Uko niko abahanga n'abashakashatsi babigenza.
That's how the researchers and the wise people they use.
Iyo hateye ibibazo nk'ibyo.
When there is such problem.
Hanyuma muri iki gihe cy'ubu rero,
and in this time of Job,
ikoranabuhanga ryari ritaragwira.
The technology was not big.
Ariko icyo nshaka kuvuga,
but what I want to say,
ni inkomoko y'indwara,
the source of this sickness.
Ndashaka kuvuga inkomoko y'ibyo rero.
I want to talk about the source of pain.
Inkomoko y'imiriro idasobanutse.
The source of unknown fires.
Inkomoko y'imiyaga n'imvura zidasanzwe.
The source of winds and conflicts.
Isoko yabyo byose.
The source of all these.
Isoko y'ibyo byose.
The source of all these bad things.
Ni Satani.
Satan.
Satani wari wihishe inyuma y'ibibi byose.
Satan was the one who was behind all those boils.
Ni wari wihishe inyuma y'uburwayi bwa Yobu.
Behind the sickness of Job.
Imana yo mu ijuru ihabwa
icyubahiro. Oh, may heaven and Father be glorified.
Bene data munkurikiye
mu mana yawe. My brother, you are watching me everywhere you are.
Ndagira ngo ubwire ko hari ikibyihishe.
I want to tell that there is something behind.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma y'uburwayi turimo kubona.
There's something behind all the sickness that we see.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma ya za Ebola.
There's something behind those Ebola.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma ya virusi itera SIDA.
There's something behind HIV.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma ya COVID-19.
There's something behind COVID-19.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma y'ibi byorezo byose n'izindi ndwara.
There's something behind all this pandemic and sickness that and there are others who will come and came.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma.
There's something behind.
Imana idufashe cyane.
May God help us.
Ubu burwayi bwa Yobu.
All the sickness that see upon Job.
Bwateguriwe mu isi y'umwuka.
They have been planned in the spiritual world.
Hanyuma Bibiliya yatubwiye ngo Satani ava imbere y'Uwiteka.
And the Bible has told us that Satan went out from the presence of God.
Agenda ateza Yobu ibishite byinshi.
And struck Job with painful boils.
Kuva mu bworo bw'ibirenge kugera mu gitwari.
From the sole of his foot up to the crown of his head.
Nshuti yanjye urimo urajya gusobanukirwa inkomoko y'ibyo bibazo urimo.
My friend, now you are being revealed about the source of all these problems.
There's
a meeting that Satan did for the spiritual world. So that he can strike your family. That he can strike your business. So that he can strike the farm of your cows. So that he come to your chicken.
Ndagira ngo mubwire hari ikibyihishe inyuma.
I'm here to tell you that there's something behind.
Hari ibyihishe, hari ikibyihishe inyuma yuko kunanirwa.
There's something behind your weakness.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma yuko gutsindwa.
There's something behind your failure.
Uryama uri muzima.
You sleep well.
Bugaca wacitse intege.
But in the morning you feel so weak.
Wirirwa uri muzima.
The whole day you are fine.
Ukira wacitse intege.
But during the evening you are weak.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma y'ibyo bintu.
There's something behind it.
Ni Satani umwanzi w'Imana n'abantu.
Satan, the enemy of God and people.
Niwe ubyihishe inyuma.
He's the one who is behind that.
Mu ntambara zose nk'uko nababwiye.
The old words that I've told you before.
Ni ikingenzi kumenya umwanzi nyakuri.
It's very important to know your true enemy.
Iyo utamenya umwanzi urwana nawe.
When you don't know the enemy you are fighting with.
Ushobora kurwana n'utari we.
You may fight with another one who is not your enemy.
Kandi wagize ingorane ikomeye cyane mu mirwano.
And it's a big problem in fighting.
Ni ukurwana n'utari ukwiye kurwana nawe.
It's to fight with the one who you are not supposed to fight.
Ngo nkubwire ko ibyo urimo kunyuramo.
I'm here to tell you that the thing that we are passing through.
Hari ikibyihishe inyuma.
There's something behind.
Igitero cya kabiri Satani yagabye kuri Yobu muri gice cya kabiri.
The second attack in this chapter 2 that Satan brought to Job.
Nacyo cyari igitero gikomeye cyane.
It was also great attack.
Yari umugore wa Yobu.
It was just the wife of Job.
Reka dusome igice cya 9 n'igice cya kabiri.
Let's read verse 9 and 10 of this chapter
2.
We are going to read Job chapter 2, verse 9 and 10.
Umugore we aramusubwira ati mbese n'ubu uracyakomeje gukiranuka kwawe hakana imana wipfire ariko aramusubiza ati uvuze nk'umwe wo mu bagore babapfapfa mbese twahabwa ibyiza mu kuboko kw'imana tukanga guhabwa ibibi muri ibyo byose nta cyahayo bu yacumurishije ururimi rwe amena.
Job chapter 2 verse 9 and 10 says in English Bible, then his wife said to him, do you still hold fast to your integrity? Curse God and die. But he said to her, you speak as one of the foolish women speaks. Shall we indeed accept good from God, and shall we not accept adversity? In all this, Job did not sin with his lips. Amen. May God be with us a lot. My friend who is watching me, I want to tell you this. This attack was also strong. And it was more stronger than other attacks that happened to Job. You might ask by yourself or ask me, how was it stronger than others? I'm going to tell you that when Satan enters in your wife's life or enter in your husband's wife, it's stronger than other wars that you can be fighting. The war that you can fight out of your life or your family, it cannot be stronger like the internal war that you are fighting in your house. And even the war into your room. Satan is so wicked. After seeing that Job won the attacks from the first, like I can call the first division, and even this second attack, which is the first and this chapter 2 that you have seen, now Satan entered in his wife. The beautiful and good wife of Job, they used to talk
very well,
that used to help each other and everything. Then he say, curse God and die. I want to reveal your secret. This wife was telling Job, this was the plan of Satan. Satan knew that to take away all this wealth of Job and even taking his kids, that he might resist and find as well that Job should bear also children. Satan knew that the sickness that is coming to Job, the time will come and the sickness will go away. But Satan entered in his wife and said, curse your God and die. Curse your God and die. Oh, may God help us. This word that Job's wife said, it has two words which are very difficult. The first word is curse your God. My brother, my sister, this is the principal plan of Satan. Want you to curse your God. Want you to curse God of Isaac and Abraham and Jacob. He wants you to curse God that was your shepherd. All the attacks that you see, all the strong walls that you see in your life, at your house,
mu muryango wawe,
in your family,
mu kazi kawe,
in your job,
ku mubiri wawe,
upon your life,
nta kindi Satani agamije.
There is no other plan of Satan.
Aragira ngo uhakane imana yawe.
Just he wants you to curse your God.
Aragira ngo uhakane imana yawe.
He wants you to curse your God.
Hanyuma wipfi.
Then you die.
Ijambo rya kabiri umugore yamubwiye.
The second word is what?
Yamubwiye ngo wipfi.
Then you die.
Wano mugamba Satan afite nshuti yange.
That is a plan of Satan, my friend.
Arashaka kuzapfa ari akanye imana.
Want you to die after cursing your God.
Arashaka kujya kuraguza.
He wants you to go to the sorcerers.
Impamvu arimo kukurwana ngo yakwicira umukobwa wa mukobwa
we. The reason why is against you, my sister want to get married and start
stopping. Arashaka
want you to get sad and go to the sorcerers.
Impamvu no gutera izo ndwara zidasobanutse.
The reason why is bringing all those unknown sickness, my brother.
Aragira ngo urambirwe ujye mu bashitsi n'abakonikoni.
He wants you to get tired and go to the sorcerers and witchcraft.
Arashaka kuyakana imana yawe.
He wants you to curse your God.
Ubu ndimo kuvugana namwe.
As I'm speaking with you,
hari abantu benshi bamaze kuyakana imana
yawe. So many people who are cursing God.
Hari abantu bahuye n'ingorane nyinshi cyane.
There are people who faced many challenges.
Hari abantu bahuye n'ibitero binyuranye
n'umwanzi Satani. There are people who met a lot of attacks with for the enemy of Satan.
Biyakana imana yabo.
Then they curse their God.
Hanyuma igikurikiraho,
then next,
ni ukwipfira.
Just is to die.
Imana iduvane cyane.
Oh, may God help us.
Hanyuma igitero cyari gikomeye cyane nacyo.
Then this great and strong attack,
nacyo yo yaragitsinze.
Even this one Job won.
Imana iduvane cyane.
Oh, may God help us.
Ndagira ngo umuntu utsinda igitero cyaturutse ku mugore we.
I want you to tell that when you win attack from your wife,
cyangwa ugatsinda igitero cyaturutse ku mugabo wawe,
or you win attack from your husband,
ubu ni umurwanyi ukomeye cyane.
You are a strong fighter.
Aba bagabo mubona b'ibihangange,
this strange man that you see,
abandi bantu bahindura imishyitsi,
that other people when they see them they trembled,
burya abantu babashobora n'abagore babo.
I'm here to tell you that people who can beat them, they are just their wives.
Umuntu ashobora kuba ari umunyacyubahiro ukomeye.
Someone might be a nobleman.
Ashobora kuba abantu bose bamwubaha bamutinya.
Might be that everyone is respecting, everyone fear him.
Umuntu ashobora kuba ari generali ukomeye cyane.
Might be like a general.
Ingabo ayobora zimutera amasaruti.
Then the armies he read, they all salute him.
Ndetse n'abandi bantu bose bamutinya bakanamwubaha.
And even other people they fear him.
Ariko umugore we akaba ari umuvuguruza.
But when his wife is the one that contradicts him.
Imana iduvane cyane.
May God help us.
Kera nkiri umwana,
when I was young,
watu hari umugabo, uwo mugabo yari umugabo munini cyane.
I remember in my region, in my places, there was a strong man.
Kandi yari akiri umusore rwose.
And he was so strong.
Yakoraga akazi kujya gucukura itini bazibye byo bitaga imparata.
They used to go and look for those precious stones when they used to go and steal them.
Kubera ko iwacu hari ahantu bacukura amabuye y'agaciro i Rwinkwavu.
Because in our region in Rwinkwavu there where you can find those precious stones.
Tugiye abo bantu bitwaga imparata bararwanaga cyane.
At those time, those group of people were called imparata, means great fighter.
Uwo mugabo yari afite umudamu muto cyane.
That man had a wife who was not so strong.
Wapimaga nk'ibiro 45 byonyine.
He had like 45 kgs.
Kandi uwo mugabo yari afite nk'ibiro 90.
But the husband had like 19.
Abasore bo mu kigero cye bose,
they are all strong, same age with that man.
Baramutinyaga cyane.
They used to fear him a lot.
Ariko umugore we,
but that wife of 45 kgs,
yirukana umugore we, yirukanaga umugabo akava mu nzu.
He used just to chase that husband.
Umugore muto w'ibiro 45.
Now you can imagine a thin wife of 45 kgs.
Yatumaga uwo mugabo ajya kurara ahandi hantu.
Caused that man to go and free from his home and go to
a yamumenaga amazi ashyushye.
Just he used to put hot water upon him and beat him the charcoal and all the materials of cooking. And they used to make that man to fear that
man.
My brother, my sister. And Satan came upon you through your wife. When it come upon you through your spouse, just he want you to curse God and die. And several men and women, when you see them going, I'm telling you they have already died. They curse God and die. That's what Satan wanted. There was something behind. May God help us. Let's read in the book of Mark. Mark, you are going to read chapter 9. Then we read verse 8 and
9.
I want to say that there's something behind.
Umwe muri bo aramusubiza ati, mwigisha, muzani umwana wanjye utewe na daimoni utavuga. Aho amusanze hose iyo amufashe amutura hasi akamubirisha ifuro akamuhekenyesha amenyo akamugagaza. Gira abigishwa bawe ngo bamwirukane ntibabishobora.
Amen. In Mark chapter 9 we read from verse 17 up to 18. Then the one of the crowd answered and said, "Teacher, I brought you my son who has a mute spirit. And wherever it seizes him, it throws him down. He foams at the mouth, gnashes his teeth, and becomes rigid. So I spoke to your disciples that they should cast it out, but they could not." May God help us. The Bible is showing us this story in Mark chapter
9.
It's a man who had a son who was dumb and he could not even speak. He used to fall down and foams. Many times he used to fall down the fire. That was his sickness. If you were to take him at the hospital, they would find the reason of the sickness. Maybe they found viruses in his brain. Oh, they start giving him maybe the treatment that can reduce that sickness. But the Bible has told us something behind the sickness, something behind this falling and mute spirit of this child, there was something behind of this muting spirit of this
child.
The Bible says that it's a demon.
It was a demon.
So this demon, the one behind this sickness. May God help us. Then they took him to Jesus. Jesus chased out this demon.
Then
the demon get out. Then that child became alive. I want to tell that those unknown sicknesses, though they might not be unknown,
there's
something behind. Me as a person who do the work of praying for the people, I saw how someone can have a problem and you find that it's when you start praying for him, the demons get out. They run away shouting. And the problem finished. There's something behind that sickness. May God help us. So let's read another story from the book of Luke. Chapter 13 from verse 10 up to
13.
Then we'll read verse 15 and 16 of that chapter.
Nuko ku munsi w'isabato yigishiriza mu isinagogi asangamo umugore ufite dayimoni utera ubumuga. Uwo mugore yari amaze imyaka 18 ahetamye atabasha kunamuka na hato. Yesu amubonye aramuhamagara aramubwira ati, "Mugore, woho ubumuga bwawe." Amurambikaho ibiganza, muri ako kanya agororoka ahagarara yemye ahimbaza Imana. Umwami Yesu amusubiza ati mwandya rya mwe mbese umuntu wese muri mwe ntazi turi nka ye cyangwa indogobe ye akayikura mu kiraro ku isabato akayijyana akayuhira kandi uyu mugore kandi uyu ko ari umukobwa wa Aburahamu akaba amaze imyaka 18 abashwe na Satani yarakwiye kubohorwa ingoyi ku munsi w'isabato.
We are going to read Luke chapter 13 from verse 10 up to 13, then we jump to verse 15 up to 16. Let's read in the name of Jesus. Now he was teaching in one of the synagogues of the Sabbath, and behold, there was a woman who had a spirit of infirmity 18 years, and was bent over, and could in no way raise herself up. But when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said to her, "Woman, you are loosed from your infirmity." And he laid his hand on her. Immediately she was made straight and glorified God. Let's jump to verse 15. Then the Lord then answered him and said, "Hypocrite, does not each one of you on the Sabbath loose his ox or donkey from the stall and lead it away to water it? So ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan has bound, think of it for 18 years, be loose from this bond on the Sabbath?" Amen.
Mana idufashe cyane.
Oh, may God help us a lot.
Muri ubutumwa bwiza bwa Yesu Kristo kubwerezwa na Luka.
This good message of Jesus Christ written by Luke.
Dusomyemo inkuru y'umugore w'amazi myaka 18 ahitanwe umugongo.
We have read bent over woman for 18 years.
Uyu mugore yaramaze imyaka yose.
This woman passed all these years.
Umugongo we warahitanwe cyane.
When he was bent over,
atabasha kunamuka na rimwe.
He could not raise herself up.
Urumva ko nta mirimo yaragishoboye gukora.
You understand that he could not do anything.
Hanyuma hari ku isabato Yesu yigishiriza mu sinagogi.
Then it was on Sabbath day when Jesus was teaching in the synagogues.
Yesu aramubona aramuhamagara.
And Jesus saw him and called her.
Ikintu cya mbere Yesu yabanje kubona.
First thing that Jesus saw.
Ni cyari kije nyuma y'uko guheta mu bwoko bw'uyu mugore.
It was what was behind the bent over of that lady. For this lady to be bent, it was not normal. But there was a demon who bent over her back. Now you can imagine 18 years. Then Jesus called her, then released her, chased that demon. Then the woman was straight over.
Aba Farisayo bagira ibibazo bikomeye cyane.
Then Pharisees had a lot of problems.
Bibaza impamvu akoze ibyo ku isabato.
They was wondering why he's doing such kind of miracle on Sabbath. Verse 15 and 16. Jesus told them, "You hypocrite. If someone, his ox or donkey, fall down in the spring,
he
could not release it.
None uyu mukobwa wa Abraham,
now this daughter of Abraham,
umaze imyaka 18 woshe,
udogo 18 years,
ntiyarakwiye kubohorwa ku isabato.
He could not be loosed on the Sabbath."
Mana y'umujuru ishimwe.
Oh, by heavenly Father be
glorified. Mwene data mushiki wanjye.
My brother, my sister.
Mukobwa wa Abraham.
Yeah, the daughter of Abraham.
Muhungu wa Abraham.
The boy of Abraham.
Ukwiriye kubohorwa.
You have to be delivered.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Ndagira ngo ufite inkuru nziza cyane.
I have a good news for you.
Imana ishaka kubohorwa.
God wants you to be delivered.
Hari kinshi nyuma y'ibyo bibazo.
Something behind all your problems that were facing.
Hari kinshi nyuma y'ubwo bumuga.
Something behind all those problems that
happened. Hari kinshi nyuma y'ubwo gusama inda zikavamo.
Something of those abortions.
Hari
something behind not getting married. There's something behind being ready for marriage and others are getting married. My brother is following me. There's something behind the conflict
in the
family. There's a demon in front of your lust of properties. The demon of sleepless.
There's
a demon behind all those
boys.
There is a demon behind that
sickness.
And because you are a daughter of Abraham. Because you are a boy of Abraham.
We
are to tell you that you have to.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Heavenly Father, to be
glorified.
The daughter of Abraham. Boy of Abraham. You have to be delivered. Behind that problems
at all.
May God be with us. The good news of Mark. Chapter 5, verse 9 up to 9. We find a man in a Gadarenian's country. The Bible used to tell us that this person used to be in the tombs.
He
was always shouting. And cutting himself with the stones. He just went out of where people used to be. And he got to live in inhabited places. Just in the tombs. This man could not wash himself. Could not even put on clothes.
There's
no chain that could bound him. Because that was his life. Then by the time Jesus came to that country, this man came and kneeled in front of him. May God help us. Then all the demons that were with him, they started telling him, child of God, where have we met? May God help us.
Yes,
Jesus asked them, how many of you? They told him, armies is our name. When you put this name, armies in Hebrews, it means that it's a region of armies that and region is between 6,000 and 8,000 people. I can imagine between 6,000 and 8,000. Those were the demons into his body, and they made him crazy. And they take out of other people. They have put him to live in
there.
May God be with us. And then Jesus revealed what is behind
us.
And told this demon to get out
of
this man. And he became fresh and alive, meet other people.
I
want to know that there's something behind what you are passing through. One day I remember when I was in Changugu.
Then
we had the conferences in a place called Shagasha.
Then
one person told me that there is a family which is my friend.
They
have a strong and difficult problem.
I
want you to go and pray for them. Then I was put in his car in the evening. Then we went at Jihunwe. That man was past like 4 years. When his wife get out of the room, they could not sleep together in the room. The wife was very dressed, dressed with a good perfume. Just he was beautiful. She was
beautiful.
But she had refused to live with her husband. Even that woman didn't know that she has been attacked. They even took him to the hospital, but it didn't work. They took that lady in the car for mental problems. problems hospital.
Hanyuma baragerageza biranga.
They tried but they failed.
Hanyuma ubugiye nari ndiyo.
By the time I was there.
Imana mishinira umudemoni wishinyuma ibyo bibazo.
God revealed me a demon behind all those problems.
Mfata ikiganza cy'umugore n'icy'umugabo.
I took the hand of that man and woman.
Nabifatanya.
Then I collected them.
Nyeje kaba demoni basenyingo.
I have commanded the demons of the destruction of
Christ
to release that woman. Get out in the name of Jesus. That night that wife returned to the room of her husband.
Okay,
Heavenly Father, my brother, my sister, I'm
going
to tell you that whatever you are facing,
there's
something behind them. I prayed for several people. Then the demon who used to cause them the problem, then those people to beat the river and be alive. I remember the servant of God called Kenneth Hagen. There's a testimony he gave. Say that someone had a breast cancer. When that cancer was about to kill her, when Kenneth Hagen started praying for that
person,
she saw a bird just getting out. She saw that bird was standing on the breast of that woman. Then she saw the bird get out through the window. Then that person immediately I'm here to tell you that cancer, there was something behind it. That another person that had a womb cancer, that's a testimony for Kenneth. And by the time Kenneth Hagen was praying for that person who was
alive,
then he saw something like a monkey getting out of that person, then run away. That person immediately get up, started praising and worshiping God. I'm
going to
tell you, even when people were
saying that cancer,
there's something behind that cancer. My Heavenly Father, be
grateful.
My Heavenly Father, be grateful.
My
brother, my sister, I invite you to follow the scripture,
talking
about the spiritual
war.
That's how you will know what we are fighting. There's something behind your problems that we are facing. It's been a month and a half. When a lady lived in Canada phoned me, then showed me the problem that she had. She had a problem of something that was crawling in her womb. And it's been 8 years when she had a husband without giving birth. She told me that she tried to go to the biggest hospital there in Canada, but they failed. And that lady called me. When I started praying for her, God revealed me that demons took her. She has been taken by 7 demons, and they took her when she was a young girl of 7 years. When I started praying, and the demons started shouting. They started shouting when they were running out. Then the 7th demon, the 7th demon was saying, no, I'm not going to leave. I don't want her to get peace. I use the power and the authority and the anointment that Jesus Christ. I told the demon, I'm going to count up to 3, then I found you out. I counted 1, 2. Without reaching to 3, the demon ran away. Now that dreading vomit a lot of things. And the demon ran away. All the demons went out. What was crying in her womb? They all went away. It's been like 4 days. I thank Heavenly Father,
Lord.
That lady called me when she was crying.
He
said, Pastor Kaitari, my father, servant of God, after 7 years, when the doctors tried but failed, God made a miracle. I met a great doctor, a doctor in you who is Jesus. He didn't only deliver me, now I have take a test, a pregnancy test, now I'm pregnant. I want to tell you, my brother
and
sister, there's a demon behind your barren. All the things that you are facing or passing through, all the problems that you have in your job, all the problems that you have in your family,
what
is passing body in bones, there's a demon behind that.
And
Jesus gave the church the
authority.
While we are praying, so many people will be delivered. May Heavenly Father be glorified.
Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Our
conferences that we do,
and
God do miracles. Demons run away.
Oh,
Satan run away. Oh, may Heavenly Father. So many people
have
this difference. The demon run away shouting. Even that sickness run away. The ladies who used to come to me, they tell me that they have a problem of
birth.
Then after chasing the demon that stopped them to be pregnant, they immediately conceive and give birth. They are more than 1,000. There's something behind all the problems. Official war. There's something behind what
we
say. God be with us.
Your
husband doesn't hate you.
Your
wife doesn't hate you. Your relatives don't hate you.
Your
neighbors don't hate you.
I
tell you that your enemies
are
Satan and demons. They are the one who
hates you.
They are the one who are behind all those who
hate you.
They are the one who are behind all those who are
spicy.
And all your do things that which are bad for you. May Heavenly Father be with us. May Heavenly Father be glorified.
We
have a lot of testimonies. It's been a few days. A man living in Zambia also watched our scriptures in 1,000 comforts. It's been 17 years with an unknown sickness. While he called me, I prayed for him then. He took time and said, Pastor, let me think just a little bit. Then he said, I couldn't remember how someone can be alive. I'm feeling life and peace that I had before 17 years. There was power of Satan,
that
spirit of wicked and witchcraft that were behind all his problems. Chapter 8 of the spiritual world, I talked about the problems that poisoners are giving to people. But I'm here to tell you that Jesus of Nazareth has power and authority. Delivering boys and girls of Abraham.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Imana
Heavenly Father be
mukobwa wa Abraham,
the daughter of Abraham,
muhungu wa Abraham,
the boy of Abraham. It's important for you to be.
Oh, hallelujah. Imana
Heavenly Father be glorified.
Tujye gusenga.
I'm going to pray.
Tujye gusenga.
I'm going to pray.
Nani mana da totu kusomu ishuru. Ndagushimiye mu izina rya Yesu.
Thank you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Ngushimiye ubushobozi n'ubasha bwawe.
Your power and authority.
Ngushimiye ko nubwo hari kinshi nyuma y'ibibazo.
The cause is behind all the problems.
Hari kinshi nyuma y'indwara.
There are something behind all the sicknesses.
Hari kinshi nyuma yo gusenya
kandi kubindi. There's something behind the destruction of the houses.
Kubintu by'abantu bawe.
Things of your people.
Ariko Yesu ufite umugambi.
But Jesus you have a plan.
Urashaka kubora abakobwa ba Abraham.
Abraham's daughter.
N'abahungu ba Abraham.
And Abraham's son.
Ni izina rya Yesu Kristo wa Nazareti.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Ndasengera umuntu wese ukuri
kibi. I pray for everyone who is watching.
Ndatsimira yose
imubuye. I cut all the chains.
Abadayimoni bakurije urubyaro.
The demons.
Abadayimoni bakurije gushaka.
The demon that is talking
about my demon that I betrayed about your
demon that betray
the demon that took your
legs. Demon that took
your legs. The
demon that took your back.
Demon wishing my your cancer.
The demon behind your cancer.
Demon wishing my your pressure.
The demon behind
your pressure.
In the name of Jesus.
Rekura.
Release.
Umwana w'Imana.
The son of God.
Now okay.
To be delivered.
Abahungu ba Abraham.
The sons of Abraham.
Na Abraham.
The daughters of Abraham.
Bakwiriye kuboga.
Have to be
delivered. Oh hallelujah. Ni izina rya Yesu
mwiza. The name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Cha buri minyiru yose.
Cut off all the chains.
Abademon basa gutumwa.
The demon that
Abademon barimo kumwambia kanimana wipfire.
That are telling you to cast out that.
Tegete bakure kure.
I command them to release.
Ndategete cyo kimba
kimwe. I command that boy.
Chivemona
get out right now.
Ndatege kugonguru kudahina
man that later that not
kangira guhina nona ha
to start
more. Ndatege ko wa dai pano kugenda
gita and all the demons that are working in your
ndiri kugenda genda mu nda
all those who are working in your
ibikuru mu bitugu
in your shoulder
ibikuru mu mugongo
in your back
nili soke nona ha
get out in the name of
Jesus. Toka mu izina rya Yesu.
Get out in the name of Jesus.
Umukoma Abraham.
The daughter of Abraham.
Umuhungu wa Abraham.
Son of Abraham.
Akwiriye kuboga.
Be delivered.
Oh hallelujah. Mane mjisho bora Dio
fe father my
ndabu shinga kwa norma
kwa hiyo kwa delivery
ni wanda wana wagabona mabore
singi nene
ni wanda wana wasoni mungu
singi yangi mena
batanye kuoka
delivery
hadi minyuri ni mabu chika ni zile Yesu Kristo urakoze Yesu wa Nazareti.
Thank you Jesus of Nazareth.
Kuku mugambi wawe
because of your
ukubo wa wahungu wa Abraham na wakoko wa Abraham
as the daughters of Abraham
urakoze Yesu wa gicho wa hiro
Jesus be glorified
ni zile Yesu Kristo
the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Mane mjisho mugisha.
Heavenly Father bless you.
Ngari kumwe namwe no Pastor Kaitari Jean Baptiste.
Pastor Kaitari Jean Baptiste.
Ndabifuriza umugisho w'Imana.
I wish you the blessing upon God.
No gusobanukirwa ko hari cyari kije nyuma y'ibazo byawe.
Be revealed that there's something behind all your problems.
Kandi umutima w'Imana
and the heart of God.
Twabonye muri Luka 13.
That is shown in Luke 13.
Umurongo 13 kugeza ku 10 umurongo 15 n'uwa 16.
Verse 15 and 16.
Nuko umukobwa wa Abraham n'umuhungu wa Abraham
is that the daughter and son of Abraham
akwiriye kubohoka
must be delivered.
Imana ibahe umugisha.
May God bless you.
Nshuti mukurikiye ibihumuriza ibihumbi.
Friends who are following 1000 comforts.
Niba ari ubwa mbere ukurikiye.
If it's your first time to watch.
Ukore subscribe cyangwa abone.
Please subscribe.
Kugira ngo ibibyisho bye bikugeraho.
So that you may follow and watch all the scriptures.
Kandi ukurikira ibice byinshi bikurikira.
I invite you to follow the next sessions.
Muzarushaho kumenya intambara turimo kurwana.
You will know very well the fight that we are fighting.
Kandi muhumure Yesu yaratsinze.
And don't worry, Jesus won.
Niba ufite ikivuzo cyangwa ikibazo.
If you had a question or a wish.
Wahamagara ku nimero ubona kuri screen yawe.
You can call for the number that you are seeing on your screen.
Mana ibamugisha mu izina rya Yesu.
God bless you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.